love the river. I love having people to come and paddle it. I want people to enjoy the river just for the river's sake. The flip side of that coin is that unfortunately the Petawawa River is threatened by a dam project to hold back and to build a reservoir and to build a head of water. That head of water will then be diverted off from around Railroad Rapid. The dam project is going in at Railroad Rapid. It'll be fed through a large tube and a series of turbines running down the river left-hand shore beside me, and it'll come back in below Suicide. That's essentially dewatering the best part of the town run of the Petawawa. It's dewatering the rapids that flow through town, the rapids along the Emerald Necklace Trail, along the town where residents can walk and see and participate in river life. And it's putting back in an area that's already developed, that's below and inaccessible to the public. It's an unacceptable loss, and it's something that really people need to be concerned about and voice those concerns to those in charge.
We really have no specific say in what happens, and it's actually really all the onus has now been placed on the province as far as permitting goes.
Say 5 years from now, there's a very real potential that the river that's flowing behind me right now will have a trickle of water left in it. To me, that would be abject failure, and it would be a big loss for the community.
In the good old days, basically, decisions affecting local municipalities, local towns and villages were made at the local level. Right now, under the Green Energy Act, that was taken away from local municipalities, and all those decisions are made in Toronto.
I mean, this is just one of many, many projects across BC, across Quebec, across Ontario, where you're seeing independent power projects or micro hydro or green hydro projects come in and threaten a lot of the rivers that we enjoy.